While interfacing with the board members of Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited, the committee chairperson, Emmanuel Otala, expressed concern about the mismanagement of the company resulting from a divided board of directors. The conflict is between the chairperson of the board, Peter Uchanda, and another board member, Richard Santo Apire, which the committee says has painted a bad image of the agency. The board is also accused of micromanaging the agency by usurping powers of management.
Particular meeting, the issue of micromanagement by the board, where we are told that for the recent year, you sat 47 times just as a board and doing basically work of management. The issue of corruption, the issue of nepotism, virtually where every board member is actually, it is indicated, has been able to bring in a relative in either at senior management level or junior management. And these are kind of the critical aspects that we would want to hear about.
About 300 million. That is micromanagement.
Why should the board be the one
to approve threshold above 300 million.
Procurement.
That is micromanagement. Such a big institute like ETCL.
The committee accused UETCL misappropriation of resources, double payment of project affected persons, and payment of people holding land titles in wetlands. It's alleged that UETCL paid out shillings 28 billion to people holding land in Namanve and Ruzira wetlands.
Payment of people holding land titles in wetlands. We've read about board members who have stayed for over 20 years in the board. So that's why you heard us in the introductions. We were keen really to find out how many years each member has served, for example.
UETCL is also faulted of inflating the compensation figures and even compensated people on government-owned land. Otala demanded that UETCL provides the committee with a comprehensive report regarding the controversial payment of 28 billion shillings on the Namanve Luzira land for the construction of the 132 kV transmission line and also produce the said land titles.
Documents relating to the compensation of the Namanve Luzira land, and that is where we want copies of those land titles and indeed any other documents of those people who were compensated in the wetlands between Namanve and Luzira. But also there is the other one that you people don't want to talk about. The same people who were compensated for the Mutundwe land.
Who then authorized the payment of the money in a wetland or in a lakeshore, as reported by the press and confirmed by the board members in a meeting that we had on Tuesday? The authorization came from the government lawyer, who is the Attorney General. And then I went further and spoke to the Attorney General this morning and told him this issue has come to the attention and you gave guidance.
Committee members also wondered how the Attorney General Chiriowa Chiwanuka aided the controversial compensation when he gave a legal opinion clearing the payment, yet his legal firm is a client of UETCL.
Attorney General, in this case, he has two courts. He has a private business with the organization.
Is that right? That's
yes,
so.
Yeah.
The Attorney General has a private.
Yes, that's what they are saying. Yes.
General, we shall take the questions.
Is the lawyer to.
The General is conflicted.
Yes.
It will only be proper that the Attorney General comes to answer these questions, since he is even more than willing to come and answer. Who triggered him? How did he write? When did he write? Why did he do this? All these questions. Mr. Chairman, I beg that the Attorney General should be here.
The State Minister for Privatization, Honorable Evelyn Anite, who led the delegation from the UETCL, pledged to resolve the impasse at the company, including allegations of corruption and the rift within the board.
We wanted to sit down to now go the reconciliation part of misunderstanding of two senior citizens fighting, presumably. The reconciliation took place and the report was sent. So we were going to the second phase of the issues of corruption, issues of nepotism, And then the committee called us.
UETCL, a limited company responsible for purchasing electricity and selling it to the distribution companies on behalf of the government, has been given 2 weeks to respond to the queries. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.